This is another, you know, issue where the finances are dwindling. The governor's even more involved in that discussion. You know, where's the path forward on that? And it seems like you keep talking about this inequity and how Chicago pensions are funded versus the rest of the state. It doesn't seem like the governor's hearing you, or is he? I mean, what are your conversations like with him? Does he just not believe in the inequity that you talk about, or how does it work?
Let me say this. I know you know that I don't talk about my private conversations. I don't think it's a good thing, because people want to say something to you in private. It's so they can explore if I take this risk with. So let me just put, here's the thing. I'm going to say this. God willing, you'll hear me. When I came into office in 2011, there were two books that were a rear. The books that our kids read and succeed on, and the finances. Mm-hmm. Now, we made changes, even in the 2012 contract. There were a lot of savings in that contract. We also closed schools that were not working educationally or financially. And we've made changes since then financially. But before I get to the finances, I have to make sure your kids were getting something educationally. Now, you can argue about how and why, and it didn't only happen under my watch. But you know about the changes on a full school day, full school year, that led to 2.5 more years of classroom time. Universal full day kindergarten. Major changes as it relates to high schools and focusing on keeping kids on track. When I came to office, our graduation rate was 57%. It's now at 70%. When we clear this year, there's going to be new data out, but we're probably going to be at 73, and our sophomores are on track to be north of 80%. We have the highest ACT scores in the history of the system. We have the highest college attendance, and our completion rate for college is now at the highest level. We just led the country in fourth and eighth grade gains on reading and math. Fourth grade math and eighth grade reading. There are only three school districts in the entire country that saw both of those areas grow on the NAEP test. That's not just because of what I've done, it's because of what teachers done. But every arrow educationally, after 20 years of where Secretary Bennett once called it the worst public school system, some places were leading the country in urban school systems. So that was the first goal. And I'm not going to shy away from the finances, but I'm not going to let the questions of finances obscure this. Gains in education. And more families now are staying in the city and going to public schools that used to go to private schools or parochial schools, because they're public schools, and close to 320 of our public schools now are one or one plus, meaning the highest, out of 600. Now, on the finances, and I say all that because we got to fix the finances so it doesn't undermine that, but we were not doing that educationally. And I'm not going to let that get blurred out of our discussion. And as I said to the state, we're 20% of the students statewide in Chicago. We're 100% of the educational gains that the state has made on graduation and test scores. And in fact, in other areas, the state has gone down where we've gone up. And if it wasn't for Chicago, Illinois would actually have been stagnant or declined in many areas. And third, we only get 15% of all the revenue that goes towards education. And it is inequitable. The governor himself has acknowledged it. He is not responsible for these two things. He's not responsible for the fact that Illinois is 48th out of 50 in funding education. And he's not responsible for the fact that the way we fund education penalizes kids because they're poor. Education should be their breakout, not their barrier. But the way we fund it, it's a barrier. Now, he is the governor, so therefore he's incumbent to fix something that he himself has acknowledged is broken. I know the politics are tough. I get it. But trust me, the politics are not as tough as poverty is on a child. Now, what I would say is when we try to deal with this, the good news is there have been senators from Quincy, Illinois, senators from Springfield, Republican, who voted to make changes because the system is also underfunding their kids, not just Chicago. Mm-hmm. And I get the politics, oh, if you play Chicago, we can all just get angry at Chicago. But that's not why Senator McCann, a Republican from Springfield, voted in favor of the reform. He wasn't doing it to help Chicago. who's going to help his constituents who are also getting the short end of the stick? The senator in Quincy, Illinois, didn't vote to help Chicago. He voted because the kids in Quincy were getting the short end of the stick. And I get other districts have done well. The head of the IBSBE, the State Board of Education, Senator Meeks, for 20 years been talking about the inequity in funding of education. We're finally now making progress. And the one thing you know, what's been talked about in hushed tones for years is now the center of discussion.